How are you?
Good, how are you?
Is that unleavened bread?
Huh?
It is unleavened bread.
I have no idea. But have like, you ever had matzo ball soup?
Soup?
Yeah.
I don't think I have.
Oh, you try it sometime. It's a great thing.
Oh, you want some?
Yeah.
I love it. It's got like chicken and stuff in
so
it.
So when she gives this to you, does it feel like racial attack? Does it feel like religious attacking of you?
Yeah.
Does?
Yeah.
Hey, he felt religiously attacked when you gave him the matzo bread.
Who did?
This guy.
Oh, I'm so
I
sorry.
I felt religious hatred when you gave that to me. You were telling me that I was wrong.
Nah, it was just Passover. We share the same first half.
And yeah, exactly. And Jesus died on the Passover. Amen.
And he was a cool dude.
Huh?
You know? Yeah, Jesus. He had a lot of things to say about farming.
Is it not amazing that all those eclipses happen on Jewish holy holidays? All set from the foundations of the world. Isn't it amazing that the cosmological model falls perfectly in line with all the Jewish holy holidays? Always have, always will. How divine can the cosmological model be? Amen.
Wait, what if they're just really good at math? I mean,
who? Well, it started with them. The covenant began with them.
We don't think that Jesus.
Also, why would you bring up the cosmological model when it includes the Big Bang Theory, which is something you don't believe in?
I believe in the Big Bang of the voice of God. I don't believe nothing created everything. I believe all of God created everything. God created people.
Do you think Tupac is dead?
Tupac was killed. By those same people who kill all the superstars who talk too much.
The United States government.
Like Michael Jackson, right? How did he die?
Matzah. Anybody. Matzah. Anybody wants matzah.
Yeah. LaToya Jackson knew.
Here you go.
Hey, where's the love?
I got folk on my hands.
She's got a lot of matzah. But the issue today is not about a lot of matzah. It's about a lot of sin going on at this university.
I got a lot of matzah. I have so much matzah, and I need to get it off my hands, y'all. Who wants to help me?
I like the matzah better.
Of course you do, because it doesn't deal with your S-I-N sin. What?
Why did you want to say the word?
Oh, for my friends that can't be here. It's a small group. It's a small gathering. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm Robbie.
Using that as a fan.
Snack and fan.
And fan. I'm loving it.
You're misusing the matzah.
I'm gonna try
what
that.
What do you use it for?
I'm gonna eat it in a little while.
Yeah.
That was nice of her to do that for us, huh? Sorry.
Do you guys get hungry out here?
It's kind of a different vibe where you don't even think hunger at the time. But
yeah,
we're
kind of fueled so by true. Anger. You know, whenever I'm protesting things, I feel the same way. I'm like, I could be doing this for like 4 days, and I'm not even gonna.
I feel like it's not just press. I feel like it's anything. You know, after a while, you just stop feeling hungry. You know, just,
right.
This is all over.
Right. Different kind of battle mode or something.
Yeah.
But I'm not. You don't think I'm angry, dude? I've been nice to you, right?
I wasn't saying that you're.
Oh yeah. Well, you think I'm angry?
I would say you're passionate.
Passionate.
Yeah. We're passionate about different things.
Yeah. Are you passionate about God at all?
Yeah.
You know, I've seen a lot of dark things to where I don't know why God would put me through that.
Gotcha. I've heard about that a lot.
Yeah.
So you consider yourself atheist now?
No.
Oh, okay.
I let people think what they think as long as it doesn't affect
it does
the
affect,
rights of other people.
It does affect everything. Because when anybody wants to live in sin, it's like someone stabbing a raft and we're all going to sink. That's what happens. Sin equals death. So I'm asking you, would you please stop
sing by demons, they know how to swim.
How do you know that?
It's Bring Me the Horizon, his shirt.
Looks like worldly entertainment over there.
Ungodly.
So some of that ungodliness. What?
Metallica?
I think if you're born again, you'll know. You'll know. God will lead you. He'll lead you away from Metallica, for sure. Can't hear you over all this jingling and jangling. What? No, he doesn't like them. That's why I cover it up.
God can see everything.
What?
Right? God can see everything.
Well, yeah, but... Well, yeah, well, my heart's changed now. I don't look at the outward appearance. I look at the inward heart. If you want to be a Jew, you have to be a Jew inwardly.
Bro, you said the N-word? Who do you think you are?
What?
You are Hispanic at most.
What? What did I say?
You said the N-word?
Which N-word did I say? I didn't say that.
What?
I did not and would not say that.
He did like 30 minutes ago.
Oh, I wasn't here for that.
What did I say? N?
Yeah.
N.
The letter.
N. I didn't say it. Didn't and wouldn't say it.
I didn't even read this part.
All of a sudden that friendly vibe went away.
Fornicators.
I forgive you. I forgive everybody for being a sinner. If that saved your soul, I'd go home. But God needs to forgive you. I know you guys think I'm special, but I'm not that special. See, the buck doesn't stop with me, it stops with God.
Are you making fun of people with special abilities? What's that? Are you making fun of people with special abilities?
What do you mean?
You just said, I know you guys think I'm special, but I'm not.
No, because they were saying that I have the power to judge them. I don't have the power to judge them or forgive them.
Hey, come dance with me, boo!
You guys are way out of time. You guys don't have very good rhythm.
Actually, I'm a music major. I'm pretty sure I have more rhythm than you.
No.
Nobody wants you here. You should just fuck.
Nobody wants you here. Go check and see with everybody else.
You go to Portland where you're from.
Who's a Nazi?
Oh, shit.
How can a Puerto Rican be a Nazi?
I get paid.
A queen. I've had.
Yep, indeed.
I'm going to go get some peanut butter. I'll see you later. Have a good day.
You too. Have a matzah latte. I want you guys to know, as a Puerto Rican, I'm not a white supremacist. Some people, they don't know that because they love their scene.
Did you see my dancing? Yeah.
What's that? What? No, I wasn't talking about gay. I was talking about skin. I am colorblind, actually.
Oh, are you racist? Like, is that something? Like,
if you're racist, you're also going to go to hell.
Well, I'm glad you said
that. If you don't love your neighbor, you're not going to go to hell.
I mean,
you're not going to go to heaven.
But you don't love your neighbor.
I love all my neighbors. I hug Jewish people, Islamic people, gay people. I hug them with the truth. I got in trouble with a lot of street preachers for giving fist bumps to sinners. I went ahead and been nice anyway. The truth of God is hard enough already. I caught you off guard. Least I could do is be nice to you. That's why I'm so nice to you guys, because I love you. The issue is not between you and me. It's between me, God, and you and God. Yeah. Yes, I have a job. A real man works for his own money. Amen. If you don't work, you don't eat. That's what the Bible says. Well, the wind is blowing my shoulder out of joint. I'm working pretty hard.
And
it doesn't. No, I pay my bills and I pay my own way to preach. If I came and preached the message of what people wanted to hear, then I wouldn't have to pay. People would pay me. Like I said, even Joel Osteen gets paid by atheists. Joel Osteen gets paid by atheists to preach a false gospel. But if you cannot find a gospel of the power of God, your gospel is not biblical. You are following a false gospel and also a false Jesus going to a false heaven. Amen. If you want to live in sin, your face is against God and God's face is against you. She's got a little bit more rhythm than the other guy. Well, she's got like an Israeli shake going on. Hi.
Hey, how you doing?
Blessings.
Are you guys with one of the local churches, or are you guys out of New Jersey?
Jersey?
I'm from Portland.
So a local church.
More Portland, yeah. We all don't live in Portland, or most of us don't live from Portland, but near there and such.
Okay. Okay, I'm mildly curious. Why choose this campus? It's a pretty fair drive.
Oh, yeah, I go everywhere.
Oh, so you're going to hit up OSU and PSU and all those?
I've been to OSU. I go downtown all the time, so I go to PSU sometimes, too.
Oh.
Yeah, man.
Well, enjoy your
Christian?
Honestly, no, I'm an atheist. But
you
it doesn't
are?
Mean I can't be civil, right?
Right, right. Thank you for your civility.
You're welcome.
Hey, and if you want to go to heaven, the Lord will reveal himself to you, so you won't have to have it in your head. You'll have it in your heart. Miraculously.
Well?
Not in your mind. Like, were you raised a Baptist?
I was not, actually.
What were you raised?
Christian non-denominational, I suppose.
Okay, did you ever experience the power of God?
No.
That's the problem, because the gospel is the power of God.
Well, so see, you the never... problem is I don't believe he exists, so how could I possibly experience
Well, did you ever seek the Lord to find him?
Yes, I did.
Okay, how did you do that?
Through the praying, repentance, and meditation that I was recommended
you
by the
You turned from sin once and for all.
I did.
And now, and you never met the Lord.
I never did.
You turned from your sin and God did not meet with you?
He did not.
Okay.
Now, I respect your right to have whatever beliefs you want, so I'm not trying to attack you.
No, you're not. I don't think you are. I'm just letting you know that I believe that what happened to me was I dealt with my sin, past, present, and future. I said, I'm never going to live like this ever again. I'm going to clean it up for once and for all. And that's what happened to me 2.5 months later on, then the Lord met me then.
Okay.
So I hope it happens to you too.
I hope so, but to be honest, I believe that sin is a man-made construct. So.
Of course you do. When you find God, he'll change your mind. He'll change your heart too.
If he exists and he finds me, then that will happen.
He will. Seek and you'll find, baby.
Hey, all right.
Love you, Nelly. What? It's happening, isn't it?
So isn't that kind of what we're doing? Like, that kind of
science? I like science. God is science. God is supernatural science, and he made natural science.
So what about the dinosaurs, though?
What about them?
This is useless.
There is. I believe in dinosaurs. I don't even think they're all gone even now. Chickens got nothing to do with them. Those are birds. Birds and reptiles are not the same, nor have they ever evolved from one to the other. And nor do we have any fossil evidence to prove macroevolution. That I know, and bless God if you know that too. That's science. There's a gentleman who's offered $250,000 for anybody who can prove macroevolution with observable evidence. No one has it. It doesn't exist. And yet you're still willing to damn your soul because you're willfully ignorant. That is the fact. You love sin.
How do you know that you're not willfully ignorant?
Because I'm willing to die on the cross with Jesus. He didn't want to die on the cross. He said anything. He said anything to let this cup pass. I don't like to obey God. My flesh doesn't want to obey God either. But if you obey God, you'll know the truth. Okay. What? You don't believe in your mom? You were born once from your mom, and now you need to be born again of your father.
I didn't come out of no vagina.
In heaven. Hey. What about round two? Round two. Oh. Atheist. The vulgarity. What's up, man?
Do you have any thoughts about the Catholic Church?
Are you Catholic? Okay. He wants to talk Roman now. Yes. Okay, here's what I'll say. Now that we're standing next to a Catholic who's also very nice. I've met Catholics who appear to be born again. I don't know. Here's the thing. The catechism is heretical. The Pope is wicked. The priests are a lot of pedophilia. Okay, but does that mean that God cannot save somebody in the Catholic Church?
Do you know that the Catholic Church is the oldest form of Christianity?
No, it's not.
Do you know that the Catholic Church created, put together the Bible that you read?
Can you go over there so everybody can hear you, or no?
I just want to talk to you.
Okay, well, okay, go ahead.
You know that the Catholic Church put the Bible together.
No, they did not.
The Bible.
No, the Roman Catholic Church destroyed the Bible.
It was a council of the Catholic Church.
Council of the Catholic Church that twisted the Bible and made the new versions.
The Bible didn't exist until the council of the Catholic Church.
No, the Bible existed in Antioch very early on.
Not in its full form.
Its full form.
And then Martin Luther altered the Bible. He took books out of the Bible.
Oh, you mean you're talking about the Apocrypha?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, besides the Apocrypha issue, there's also Antioch versus Alexandrian issue, mm-hmm. Alexandrian Egypt issue as well. The King James Bible came from where the apostles were, and the Alexandrian Egypt is the text that underlies all new versions. Mm-hmm. So no, it's not okay to say that the Catholics did it. The Catholics gave you Alexandrian Antichrist Egyptian versions, and the King James Version is the one that came from the apostles. That's the New Testament. So
the King James Bible is the same Bible.
No, it's not.
That I read.
Well, no, it's not. You read like something that's related to like the NIV or something like this.
I do not read the NIV.
Okay, what Bible do you read? And if you look up Acts 8:37, would it say something about what you have to do to be water baptized? It's not going to be in your Bible because you're the one who took it out. The answer to the whole setup between Philip, huh?
You do have to be water baptized.
Yeah, but it says, okay, the argument between Philip and the Ethiopian was an issue of what must you do to be baptized water-wise.
Yeah.
Okay, the problem was that the answer is taken out of all the Bibles, including the Catholic Bible. Uh-huh. So why all
What's
that setup,
answer?
Huh?
What's the answer?
You have to believe in the Lord Jesus Christ
That's
with all your
Bible.
Heart, huh?
That's in my Bible.
Check, do you have a Bible on you now?
I do, yeah.
Okay, we're going to look at the Catholic Bible, and I'll prove to you that it's missing a very important verse among hundreds of others.
Let's do it. All
right, and also, I want to know, what kind of cross did Jesus die on?
A Roman cross.
He died on a Roman cross.
You said Acts what?
Hey, I'm not allowed to discuss what sinners do in private.
Then how are we supposed to know if we're sinning or not?
By the letting of the Holy Ghost. Jesus Christ is a light. Keep your eyes on Jesus and you'll know the truth from error by looking at the resurrected Savior.
Acts what? You said?
Acts 8:37.
Hey.
He's a Catholic.
Yeah, I'm not with them.
Hey, come over and debate with me then.
It's like the body and blood of Christ.
If your Bible doesn't have Acts 8:37, get a new Bible. I recommend the real Bible, the KJV. It doesn't have anything missing. It's the full deal. Why take the Word of God apart to match heretical doctrines of the Roman Catholic Hell Church?
So, look, here's some water. Is there anything to prevent my being baptized? And Philip said, if you believe with all your heart, you may. And he replied, I believe that Jesus is the Son of God.
37? Oh, it's in there.
He ordered the chariot to stop.
What Bible is that?
This is the New Jerusalem Bible, a Catholic Bible.
Okay, look at Matthew 7:1.
Okay.
Curious. This is where the... Huh? It says it. Jerusalem Bible. It also has, judge not lest ye be judged.
Matthew
7:1. That's where it says it at.
Yeah.
Judge not lest ye be judged. It comes from the New Jerusalem Bible. The one that no one's ever heard of, but somehow they all say it from that one. That weird?
Do not judge and you will not be judged. That's
what does it say?
Do not judge and you will not be judged.
Oh, okay. It doesn't say that. I can't remember. I thought it was one of the Hebrew-y, Messianic Jewish type of Bibles or something.
Oh, yeah.
So, does it bother you that Rome was the Babylonian spirit in history that killed Jesus, killed many Christians, killed Peter?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Right, yes.
Okay, and then later on?
That's the Rome, the pre-Christian Rome, the pagan Rome did that.
Okay.
Christ defeated Rome. Christ, they tried to kill him and they couldn't. And now Rome serves God. Rome has become an instrument of God. They tried to kill him and they couldn't. And now God, and now Rome is ruled by Christ through his vicar, the Pope of Rome.
Okay, to you, what does vicar of Christ mean?
It means he stands in for Christ. Christ is the head of the church. The Pope is his regent. His vicar, his priest on earth.
And you believe that he's telling the truth right now?
That the Pope is?
Do you believe the current Pope is telling the truth right now, even though he's honoring evolution?
The Pope...
He honors homosexuality?
He does not honor homosexuality.
Is that not true?
That's not true. The church does not condone homosexuality. And the Pope does not. The Pope has not changed church teaching right now.
I've heard a lot of different things about that. Are you sure?
I have my catechism. It still says...
Okay, does your catechism say that God sent his son to make men God? How do you interpret that?
Well, we're supposed to become like God. We share in God's life. We are in union with
Christ. No, it said to make men, capital G-O-D, God. That's why God sent his son to make us that way.
That's what a saint said, who was St. Irenaeus, who was taught by St. Polycarp, who was taught by the Apostle St. John. That's an apostolic teaching. It's not a literal way of speaking, though. It's a way of speaking that means we're supposed to be in union with Christ. Paul says that it is no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me. Mm-hmm. Christ lives in us. We become Christ, other Christ, what's a Christian's means. And then we enter into the life of the Trinity in the place of the Son. We share the divine life for all eternity. That's heaven.
So
we become.
You
like
don't
God.
Believe
we
we're going to become. So being an other Christ.
Yeah.
Is a really weird doctrine. I know the Bible says that ye shall become, you shall be like as gods or something like that. So mm-hmm. I don't even know what that really means. But I do know that calling us other Christs is kind of weird.
Christ wants to share his
because Antichrist
life with
means other Christ. Doesn't that seem
no,
a little strange?
No, that means against. Anti means against.
Not only against, but it also means it means both. But anyways, is that not true?
I don't think that's true.
Okay, well, what about the Whore of Babylon? It says that the city on seven hills, is that not Rome?
That's pagan Rome, yeah.
Pagan
that's
Rome?
The
okay, are they both going on at the same time?
Pagan Rome.
Are they both simultaneous right now?
No.
Oh, it's been taken over. Papal Rome take over pagan Rome?
Yeah. Rome is a Christian city. Rome is the eternal city of Christ's dominion on earth. The center of the kingdom of God on earth.
So is it not amazing that where in history do you ever see God's true people being in power like they are like that? When has that ever been true?
The Jews had an empire. The Davidic kings were a dynasty of kings that ruled an empire for many years before they were conquered by the Persians and the Babylonians and etc.
Okay.
But the Jews, they had many kings and they were very powerful. They had dominion over different peoples. They conquered Canaan. They had power over the Canaanites. And the destiny of Rome.
Okay. And now in the New Testament, you think it would be the same?
I think Christ, he takes what was before and he perfects it. So he takes the Davidic kingship that was thinking of it as an earthly temporal government, and he makes it into a spiritual government that will extend over the whole world that's centered in Rome. The church is the new Israel. The Roman church is the new
Israel. All right, well, I don't know how you're saying that the guy's not standing for all this. Like, I mean, the ecumenical movement alone should be enough to scare you to death about the Roman church. Because they're uniting all kinds of different people of all religions and saying that it's all the same is not okay.
That's not true. We don't allow non-Catholics to receive our communion. We're very careful about who we
allow.
Okay,
so then the last three popes would be anti-popes in your eyes?
No.
Because they did do that in 1986. I've seen the council. I have a video about it too.
I made it.
There's two. There's one in the 60s. They're black and white one, and there's also one footage in 1986. 186 different leaders of all different religions, uh-huh. And the Pope said they're all worshiping the same God. I'm talking like soothsayers and witch doctors and everything.
Well, you were saying yesterday I was here that God shows himself in different ways to all people, but they misinterpret it and that, you know, they get it wrong. But God does. All truth is from God, right? Right? I mean, God is true.
Wait. Are you telling me that a Shinto warrior, a soothsayer, a witch doctor is all going to go to heaven?
No, probably not. But I'm saying that if they say anything true, it's because it comes from God. And a lot of them don't say very much that's true.
But you can't.
But for instance, other Christians, like Protestants, do say a lot that is true. Not everything. But they say a lot that's true. And whatever they do say is true is from God. Right?
Elizabeth!
And so all the truth that anyone knows